Hello and welcome back to Open, everyone. Don't forget to get social with us. That's right. Tweet us at Bronxnet TV. And while you're there, tweet me too, at Rhina Valentin. My Time is a new upcoming play that tells the story of a woman dealing with divorce. The presentation depicts the experience through seven stages of grief, shock, denial, guilt, anger, bargaining, depression, and reflection. Our next guest plays the character sharing this oh-too-common story. And joining us to tell us more about the play, My Time, please welcome actress Francesca Van Horne. Hello and welcome.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
Good morning to you. And let's talk about the topic at hand and how common it is.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate because it is kind of becoming a norm within our society. And I understand A.R. Garcia wrote this, which I find even more fascinating because you're performing a play from a woman's perspective that was written by a man.
Exactly. And that's part of what drew me to it so much. I respect A.R. so much as a person as well as an artist, because he has this ability that I think really only a true gentleman who's really strong within their center can successfully process and portray. And within that, you know, he's able to really be vulnerable and to really, he must really listen to women in real life, at least that's been my experience, because his writing, you wouldn't know that a man wrote it. So I think that's pretty fascinating.
That is fascinating because you're performing it, right? And so you were able to just kind of dive inside and see if the authentic voice is coming through, right? Considering it's being written by a man. Now let's talk about the different emotions that this show incorporates. And so I'm curious to know, because obviously you're still in development and you haven't been mounted yet, right? Do you have a moment for each emotion? Like, does each emotion identify a character within the show, since it's a one-woman show?
That's a good question. I've been exploring a lot of that, and what I find that's interesting is I have a different sort of character process that I work with. So let's say I'll go as Anna one day, and I'll literally do a shopping exercise where I'll go as she would. What would she buy? What would she wear? You know, I sort of inhabit that. And while I'm doing that, I'm running the lines through, you know, through my head or out loud sometimes. Hopefully people don't think I'm totally nuts.
You know, well, it's New York.
Or they don't know I'm totally nuts. What I think one scene is about emotionally, it ends up being something entirely different. So that's kind of the interesting journey that I've had so far, and we'll see once we actually put it up on stage, is that one scene that I think is about anger is actually about denial. Another scene that I think is about bargaining, it turns into something else. So it's just this interesting arc.
Yeah, I'm listening to the dynamics and I'm trying to visualize. And so the show itself is how long? How many?
Just under an hour.
It's under an hour. And how many characters do you play within the one-woman show?
Well, this is the first one-woman show where I only play one woman.
Right, you play one woman, yeah, you say that, but I can kind of already get the sense, even though I'm not even part of the process, that those emotions serve as characters.
Because
you're one person being a different person in different situations.
Exactly. Okay, so good point. So part of that, the emotion is, one moment she's the dutiful, you know, Latina housewife. The next minute, she's saying that she keeps her cool, but she's, you know, more sassy and really has a temper. So there's this sort of that. And then she has another moment where she's just like talking to a girlfriend, talking about sex. And that's more like you get this sort of, I think every woman can relate to it, right? We don't stay in a sadness every moment of our lives, even if you're going through something. So there are these different characters through her that as she develops, you know, that she acts. Even also the little girl of her that really is, I think, had this vision, I think most of us have, that the knight in shining armor would whisk her away and she'd have this fairy tale ending. But what is really the ending? There isn't an ending. So the idea is this, it's circular, you know, it comes back.
It's a cycle. Uh-huh, it's a cycle that repeats itself until she gets to the root of what it is that keeps attracting the same momentum.
Exactly.
Right. And yeah. So I'm curious. You just said the something that, wait, what? How did you, are you Latina?
I grew up in Argentina. Uh-huh. My mother is Italian, actually from the Bronx. but so I just grew up in that culture. And I've played quite a few Latina characters in film. And that's actually where I met AR. Was the movie St. Nicholas, and I played the Latina guidance counselor, or therapist, rather. So I do definitely resonate with those stories. Also, I have a couple other projects as a producer and writer that I'm working on. One is called Two Sisters, and it was a Colombian play, and I played one of the Colombian sisters. So then I got the rights, and I'm making it into a TV show. So, you know, I really do have a simpático.
Yeah, well, yeah. Is it because you grew up in Argentina?
That's a big part of it, yeah.
Yeah, so that's lovely, though. Yeah. I love that we come in all colors and that you're portraying them, or that you choose to portray it, right? Because it's kind of like how you feel you've been raised.
Yes, for sure. And that's been the warmest, most incredible parts. My father is totalmente gringo, but he has this, he was an Argentophile, that's what they call him. And he, you know, would do all these research for books and wrote all of these books about Latin America and had three Latino wives. So, you know, right. Well, my mom's not really Latina. She's
well, she is kind of sort of.
But she is kind of sort of.
Well, it's a Latin, you know, language. Yeah, so, yeah.
Exactly. All right.
Yeah, exactly. So my time, before we go, what do you want people to know about this story before we go? And, of course, we got to tell them the dates that it's going to be presented.
Yes. I think that my time is definitely a woman's story. But as we were speaking about, you know, a man wrote it because he's also gone through those stages of grief. And I think whether it's through a divorce or just loss in general, we all navigate these different waters. And what I'd like to do is I'm hoping that I can tell the story effectively so that the audience really serves as a healing and as a catharsis that they might not necessarily be able to voice or pinpoint, but hopefully when they come to see the show, it'll soothe some of that
alleviate
angst.
Some of that mm-hmm. weight that they've been carrying and holding and suppressing, as a lot of us in society tend to do. So it's lovely to work with and know artists who are conscious in what they're presenting. So
I want to make you laugh, I want to make you cry. Those are my two goals.
Awesome. Yeah. And that's the most effective healing method as far as I'm concerned.
For sure.
They're both nice forms of release.
Yes.
All right. Awesome. Oh, Francesca,
thank you so
looking
much.
Forward to seeing that too. You guys, my time, it's going to be performed from April 24th through April 27th, and that's happening at Teatro Latea NYC, located at 107 Suffolk Street. And for tickets to see My Time, you can visit mytimeeventcombo.com. We have to take a quick break, but when we return, we'll hear about a new exhibition in the Bronx. Don't go anywhere.